Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Before I start my words, I would like to congratulate everyone who managed to be here despite COVID-19 and thank you for your participation. One of the most important criteria of whether people live in prosperity or not is the gross national product. It is thought that more work and production are required for more income. To produce more, it is necessary to consume more energy. When the source of this consumed energy is not questioned, various damages can occur both locally and globally. Sustainability is becoming more and more important, both in the world and in Turkey. For a more livable world and Turkey, temporary solutions should be replaced by permanent and voluntary practices. Governments also have some responsibilities at this point. I like to state that Turkey signed the Paris Climate Agreement, and the name of the Minister of Environment and Urbanization in Turkey became the Minister of Environment, Urbanization and Climate Change. As it said, time for turning commitments into action, but not only in Turkey, but also in the world. Renewable energy sources are one of the most important keys to sustainability, and swapping the needed energy with renewable energy sources instead of sources that harm nature will provide a more livable country and world. So today we will try to give information about two main issues. The first one is financial overview of renewable energy production in Turkey, and the second issue is climate finance through green and social impact bonds. Ms. Aksoy and I will give information about the first issue, and Mr. Mazak and Mr. Tekar will give information about the second. By the way, we are academicians working at Süleyman Demirel University. Meanwhile, Süleyman Demirel University is a state university located in the Mediterranean region of Turkey. Let's start my presentation. I want to start with world energy total consumption, but before that, let's remember what are renewable energy types: solar, photovoltaic, wind, hydropower, bioenergy, concentrated solar power, geothermal, and biofuel. When we look at the world energy total consumption, I cannot give you good news. Oil continues to hold the largest share of the energy consumption with the percentage of 31, and the coal is with percentage of 27. The share of natural gas is 24.7%. Good news, renewables rose record highs of 5.7 respectively, and renewables has now overtaken nuclear energy, which makes up only 4.3 of the energy mix, and hydro share is 6.9, the first increase since 2014. And the second slide shows us the renewable electricity generation by technology between the years 2010 and 2025. This is different from the first one, the first graph, because that was the total energy consumption, and this is the electricity. This is focused on electricity. There is a green line, as you see, above all the lines, good news. From 2010 to 2025, the old renewables score increased from 4,000 unit to 10,000 unit. There is an estimation here. This score will be by 2025. And here, renewable electricity net capacity additions by technology between 2013 to 2022 main and accelerated case. Here we can mention solar PV is increasing year by year, and wind also. This graph shows us the renewable electricity net capacity additions by country and regions. I would like to focus on the first three one. China, United States, and European Union. With the year 2021, there is an increase in China, both in United States, but in the European Union region, there is an increase, an estimation, 2022. And one good news about, again, renewable energy highlights. The graph on the x-axis shows the years from 2019 to 2025. As you see, the green is increasing very sharply. So that is good news. And coal seems to go decrease by 2025. So it is also good news for us. And there are some highlights I would like to mention about world's energy production. Total installed wind and power photovoltaic capacity surpasses coal by 2024. Total wind and solar capacity doubles between 2020 and 2025. Wind and photovoltaic total installed capacity surpasses that of natural gas in 2023. And renewables will become the largest source of electricity generation to surpass coal in 2025. And I would like to give some information about Turkey's position on renewable energy with macro numbers. Then Ms. Aksoy will give some specific data about renewable energy finance. Turkey's energy system is characterized by a large share of fossil fuels, and while nearly all of the oil and gas consumed is important, but all types of renewable energy are produced domestically in the country. Domestic energy production covered 31% of total energy in supply in 2019. Renewable energy production has more than doubled since 2009, with rapid growth in geothermal, hydro, wind, and solar, while the use of traditional bioenergy for residential heating has increased also. What about the consumption? Industry is the largest energy consuming sector, accounting for a 1/3 of total consumption in 2018, and followed by transport 27%, and residential 20%, and services 17%. Here we see the energy production by source in Turkey between the years 2000 and 2019. Domestic energy production in Turkey increased by 59% between 2014 and 2019, mainly driven by the expansion of renewables of coal. Here is something different from the world. The geothermal energy is increasing very highly in Turkey. As I know, we are in the second rank in the world. Fossil fuels continue to drive Turkey's economy with a heavy dependency on imports, especially oil and gas. And renewable electricity generation has nearly tripled in the last decade, and its share in total power generation reached 44% in 2019. Under the renewables energy support mechanism, which is called in Turkish YEKDEM, Turkey offered feed-in tariffs for renewable power plants, including wind, solar, biomass, and hydro and geothermal. This graphs is showing us the renewable energy as a share of total final energy consumption in member countries of International Energy Agency. And Turkey ranks 20th out of 30 countries here. The first country is Norway, the second Sweden, Greta's country, and the third Finland. Here we see renewable energy electricity generation with the number of 2019. Hydropower dominates renewable electricity generation in Turkey, but other sources have increased rapidly in the last decade. Just now it is over than 50%, not 45. This is the number with the year 2019. So as today, it is over 50. Additional support is provided if plant components are manufactured in Turkey, renewables in electricity generation. Given the strong renewables growth that Turkey has experienced in the past decade, more recently, the government increased the target to 38% of renewables in power generation by 2023. As part of these efforts, Turkey plans to commission 10 gigawatt each of solar and wind capacity in the period between the years 2017 and 2027. The targets for wind and solar are easily achievable since significant proportion has already been realized. And more finance data, as most of us know, Borsa Istanbul is the only stock exchange performing in Turkey where the stocks are traded. Total number of companies in Borsa Istanbul is 385, and number of sustainability index companies 59, number of electricity index companies is 17, number of renewable energy producing companies 11. Here is a ratio, percent of renewable energy companies to electricity index companies is 65%. So in the last 3 or 4 years, there has been really popular construction of renewable energy companies. Also, here is a slide. There should be a slide, but yeah, here. In this slide, I would like to mention the initial public offerings in 2021. Why did I put these numbers here? Because initial public offerings in recent years, I mean this year and last year, very popular for renewable energy companies. Number of total IPOs, I mean the initial public offerings in 2021 is 41. What is IPO? The first step of companies stock selling to both individual and institutional investors. And the number of renewable energy companies is 8 over 41. Percentage of renewable energy companies is 20% of the whole company is renewable energy companies. When we look at the market capitalization, we also have a percentage of 26. Here, my last slide, I want to show three indices here. The blue one and the red one. Blue one shows us the main index of Borsa Istanbul. On the x-axis, we see the years 2017 to 2022. While we start from 2017 to date, we also see the red graph. It shows us the electricity index. And on the right side, we see the, how much did they increase from 2017 to now? It's for 115% for the main index, but it is 265% for the electricity index. This also shows us the interest to electricity producing companies. My slide is over, and I just want to give the floor to Ms. Aksoy. Ms. Aksoy will give us information, more specific information about renewable energy companies and sector. Thank you.
Pardon. Slide, efendim?
Sorunumuzu açmadınız.
Hayır. Yok.
Diğer tarafa geçelim mi isterseniz? Şöyle bir çıkalım mı?
Hello everyone, my name is Esra Aksoy. I am a research assistant at Süleyman Demirel University in Turkey. Today I will give you basic information about Turkey Renewable Energy Finance. Today Turkey is leading country in the isn't is region is renewable energy. The share of renewable energy sourced in electricity installed power is 52.3%. The reason is which is the ratio Turkey ranks 6th in Europe and 13th in the world. At the same time, Turkey's hydroelectric power plants is in the second plants in Europe and 9th in the world in terms of installed power. The look for renewable energy in Turkey. First one, Turkey has gridable its renewable energy capacity in 20 years. Nearly half of the total installed power capacity in based on renewable energy source as of the end of 2019. Second one, investing in renewable energy in Turkey increased to $1.9 million in 2015. Another one, Turkey became the second country in the world to increase its geothermal capacity in most, right behind Kenya, with a geothermal capacity of 209 megawatt in 2014. Last one, a capacity increase of 1,352 megawatt in hydroelectric investment in 2013, Turkey is fourth country in the world with the highest hydroelectric capacity, with highest hydro capacity increase after China, Brazil, and Canada. And recent in Turkey, renewable energy, recent news in Turkey. October 2021, the credit will be used to finance energy, efficiency, and renewable energy projects. That's the Development and Investment Bank of Turkey provided $1 million of loan from Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank. September 2021, the share of renewable energy in Turkey has increased to 53%. The share of renewable power plants on total electricity capacity rose to 53% of the end of the August 2021. The economic size of investing in Turkey renewable energy sector, which reached a capacity of 52,353 megawatt by the end of August 2021, reached $66 million. And the other, July 2021 renewable energy project in Turkey had the potential of 110,000 new employment. It is predicted that with the existing renewable energy project stock in Turkey, an additional capacity of 9.2 gigawatt and new employment for 110,000 people can be provided. April 2021, Vodafone Turkey reached its 100% renewable energy target. Vodafone Turkey became the first and only operator to use 100% renewable energy in the entire network. This is good news for Turkey. Over the years, Turkey has formed successful partnership with multilateral development bank, which include project to reduce greenhouse gas emission. Project usually involve grants and cancellation loans from multilateral funds such as the Global Environment Facility and Climate Investment Fund. Since the Global Environment Facility inception, Turkey has received Global Environment Facility grant totally around $111 million that leverage $1.1 million in private sector co-financing for 34 national projects. Turkey has received approximately $435 million from the Clean Technology Fund, and the amount of co-finance in the same period exponent me $4.9 billion. Turkey took part in 34 region global environment facility project totally around $299 million, and this project have mobilized a total of $1.3 billion in co-financing. Renewable energy support mechanism in Turkey, feed-in tariffs. The growth in Turkey renewable sector is underpinned by the government policy support schemes. In addition, under the renewable energy support mechanism, Turkey offered 10 years feed-in tariffs for renewable power plants. So, renewable energy support mechanism in Turkey offer feed-in tariffs for renewable power plants, including wind, solar, biomass, hydro, and geothermal. It is estimated that in 2019, the renewable energy support mechanism scheme paid 6.41 billion dollars in investments in 770 renewable facility with a total capacity of 20.9 gigawatt. And last one. In a general summary, this data supports the tendency to invest more in renewable energy generation source in Turkey as well as in the world. Thank you for listening.
Now we're listening Mr. Mazak.
Okay. Thank you for presentation, Mr. Aksoy. Good morning, everyone. I am Mehmet Mazak and working as a research assistant and finance and banking department at Süleyman Demirel University from Turkey. Today, I would like to inform about climate finance mechanisms. And I only take 10 minutes. And after me, my colleague, Mr. Teker, will continue our presentations. Let's start. Climate finance. What's climate finance is first part. As you know that Paris Climate Agreement aims to keep global temperature increases below 1.5 degrees Celsius. And in this scope, climate finance refers to financial support from developed countries to developing countries to support their efforts to address climate change and issues. And also, these funding mechanisms can be doing through public sources and private sources. And let's go on to the climate finance mechanisms. How does it work, actually? And prior to Paris Climate Agreement, Global Environmental Fund, all financing mechanisms was managed by Global Environmental Fund. Global Environmental Fund basically raises capital from developed country and provide transactions to developing countries through loans and grants. After the Paris Climate Agreement, Green Climate Fund has been established. And Green Climate Fund is shown to be a main financing fund by government. In addition to these fund mechanisms, there are also bilateral commitments, multilateral development banks and organizations, and private sector commitments are used for financing climate issues. And let's move on to the total value of climate finance mechanisms and climate finance provided and mobilized total value, as you know that, as you show that. And annual financial support in $100 billion was targeted COP16. As you can see, we haven't reached this goal yet. And just a second, I will check the data. According to the OEC data, in $80 billion was provided all financing mechanisms to finance climate issues. All finance mechanisms, by the way, includes private sector's contributions, bilateral public commitments, and multilateral organizations and funds. And as you can see in the figure, in the top color of the line, private contributions, which includes raised capital from public and public and multilateral organizations, which only mobilize its total amount of $14 billion. And in order to reach financial support goals, which means $100 million annually, private sector commitments, contributions must increase. And mobility of capital is not only area where private sector and financial industry provide the contributions to climate finance. And climate bonds, especially, can be seen one of the most effective solutions to climate finance. As you can see in the screen, climate finance, climate bonds is the fixed income financial instruments, and can be issued by governments, multinational banks, or corporations, and specially named as green or sustainability bonds. And climate bonds basically not only provide capital to climate funds and multinational corporations, but also enables the private sector to develop their green projects. And at the same time, climate bonds markets provide help increasing private sector mobile's role in financing mechanisms. Because deeply financial markets and diversity financial instruments and rising private capital could provide increases private sector contributions in mobile's financial mechanisms. That's why we care about the climate bonds as a new financial mechanisms. And finally, we will look at the Turkey's climate finance perspective. When evaluated to Turkey's in terms of financing mechanisms, not being as evaluated as a developing country in terms of climate green climate fund, it counts to not benefit from financial support. This is the negative situations for our country. On the other hand, its beneficiary positions in terms of the Global Environmental Fund, it provides to capital national projects amount $140 million, and it provides to multinational projects amount $348 million. This is the good news for us. But actually, it seems that the great capital potential for our country is that international investors will come to our bond market rather than the beneficiary positions. Because Turkey is being a part of the Paris Climate Agreement, it will attract the attention of global investors. Thank you for listening now, and my colleague Mr. Teker will continue the climate bonds presentations and will show you some significant and statistical insights. Thank you.
First of all, I want to say welcome to everyone, and I want to say I'm very proud of to be here. I'm coming from Süleyman Demirel University, Turkey, and I'm working finance and banking department. I'm a research assistant. My friend Mr. Mazak talked about social bonds is the first of three type of climate bonds. Here we will talk about other two climate bond types: sustainability bonds and green bonds. I'm sorry. We will touch on three topics this page, this presentation. First one is description of green bonds and sustainability bonds. Second one is world statistics, sustainability bonds and green bonds, and last one is overview of Turkey. Green bonds are debt instruments used to finance green projects that deliver environmental benefits. Green bonds are financial instruments whose policies are predominantly used to partially or fully refinance new and or existing climate or environment-related projects. For example, renewable energy, energy efficiency, pollution prevention and control, and clean transportation. We are seeing three circles on this page. Left one is green bonds, right one is social bonds, and as you see, they have intersection parts. This is sustainability bonds. It's understood that certain social projects may also have environmental co-benefits and that certain green projects may have social co-benefits. On this page, we can see total climate bonds issuance so far. The big box, the blue box, is referred to green bonds, firstly. And secondly, orange part is referred to sustainability bonds. And last one, gray part, is referred to social bonds. You can see approximately 67% is green bonds, all of total climate bonds volume. We can see $1.3 trillion volume has green bonds only. And social bonds and sustainability bonds is exceeded $315 billion. This map details total green bonds issuance by continent. We are seeing the first one is the ranking, Europe. Europe has until today $590 billion green bonds issuance. And second one is, you can see North America. On the other hand, the last one in the ranking, Africa. Africa continent is has only $4 billion green bonds issuance. This page, we can see green bonds issuance by year until today. As you see, every year has little increase, but especially 2017 and 2020 has dramatically increased, but this year is the highest level. This map details total sustainability bonds issuance until today. Similarly, green bonds, we are seeing Europe is the best, Europe is the most ranking. Europe has $75 billion issuance. And second one is not North America this time. Second one is Asia Pacific this time. On the other hand, Africa is zero. Africa has not any sustainability bonds issuance until today. Here, this page, we are seeing sustainability bonds by year. We are seeing increase every year except 2016, but similarly, green bonds this year has the highest level, $157 billion sustainability bonds only this year. Now, we want to talk about climate bonds issues by Turkey. We are seeing Turkey reached the highest amount in green bond, also sustainability bonds issues at this year. We are seeing the graphs since 2016. We have too much sustainability bond and green bond issuance, but until today, green bonds total issuance volume exceed $1.8 billion, and sustainability bonds total exceed $3.3 billion. Totally, climate bonds issuance by Turkey exceed $5 billion until today. This is timeline about climate bonds issuance at Turkey. We are seeing since 2016 first issuance by Turkish Turkey Industrial and Development Bank has volume $300 million. And we are seeing until today totally, I think, 18 issuance has green bonds and sustainability bonds issues here. But I want to touch only three important issues this page. First one is, I said before 1 minute, Turkey Industrial and Development Bank made first sustainability bond issuance before 5 years ago. The biggest sustainability bonds issued made by Vakıfbank is public bank at 2020 years. And the biggest green bonds issued made by Aydem Enerji. This issuance has volume $750 million. Here I will say something about issuer type. The banking sector issued 69% of the climate bonds issued in Turkey. The number and volume of issuance are, of course, important, but there is something more important. There are only 23 countries issuing sustainability bonds in the world at last year. Turkey is one of them. And our issuance volumes are getting bigger every year. I think this is promising for our country. Thank you for all of listeners, and special thanks to everyone who working for organization COP26. Thank you very much.
If there are questions, we will try to answer your questions. Thank you for listening.